Here we are on our Windows 10 desktop. Welcome to our conversation about the home groups and work groups. Let's start first talking about a work group. Now to get started, we're here in Windows 10. I'm going to click on my start button and we're going to search for control panel. And when we find control panel, we're going to click on it and we're going to open up the control panel. In the control panel, I'm going to head over to system and security because this is where a lot of our options are going to be. And we're going straight over to the system. When I click on system, we can check out some info about our system here. But what I want to focus on right now is this word work group. I'm going to click on that change settings button right here on the right side of domain name and workgroup settings. And when this opens up, we get some options. We can do something about network ID or to rename the computer or change its domain or workgroup, click change. Well, before we click that button, let's go a little bit deeper into what is a domain or work group. So as we chat about it, workgroup versus domain. What is a work group? Well, a work group, it's really a very simple network setup. Each user is able to control their own username and password on their machine, as well as able to control what files and folders and even printers and other external devices can be shared on a network. With a work group, it's really meant to be a peer-to-peer style setup. There's no dedicated server that's going to have files stored on it. So, work group and domain? Domain is the idea of having a network domain. And with this network domain, you're going to have a server. And this server can be your centralized place to house files and folders, even attached printers. This server as well can control all your username and password accounts, where a user can travel anywhere in the business, sit down at any computer, and log in with their credentials, which are being logged in on this server. Now, the idea of having a domain versus a work group, the domain is going to be this centralized control for those files and folders where they're password protected on the server and not having everything locally saved on every single individual machine. This is much easier to manage in the long run. It's just a little more complex to set up than our original idea of just a work group where users control their own files, their own folders, their own user accounts, and their own attached devices plugged into their machines. So let's go back on over to our Windows 10 machine and go a little bit further into this idea of workgroup settings. So in our Windows 10 machine, if we wanted to join a workgroup and be able to easily share files and folders with other computers, we would go ahead and click this change button. And what we'll find is by default, your computer has a name that identifies it on the network. Also, the default workgroup we see here in Windows 10 is just workgroup. And here it is in all caps. And as long as you have the same workgroup name on all your Windows 10 clients, they're going to be able to see each other and possibly share files and folders. Possibly, because it depends on the permissions that are set. So if we wanted to change it, I can go ahead and change this to work domain. But it's going to tell me to do something after I click OK. And what it wants, it's going to want you to do a reboot. So welcome to the workgroup domain workgroup. Click OK. And yeah, you've got a reboot for that to take effect. Now, it's not a good idea for you to change that unless you need to. Keep it as the default of workgroup. Now, there's another thing we want to talk about, which is going to be home group. So I'm going to go ahead and let this Windows 10 OS reboot. And while that's rebooting, it's time for us to head to Windows 7. Ooh. Well, with Windows 7 and Windows 8, and also the early release of Windows 10, they all supported something known as home group. Now, the idea here of home group is it's supposed to be an easy method for us to share files, folders, and guess what? Attached printers with other people on your same local network. This idea of home group also was not really meant for business. It did beautifully for Windows 7, Windows 8, and then the beginning of Windows 10, it was there, but then it's been removed in Windows 10. So what I can do in my Windows 7 machine here is I can choose what I want to share with other people on my home group. After I choose those items, I can click next, and it's going to go through the process of attempting to share these with other people on the same home group. And the only restriction is this simple password. So I would go ahead and click print password and instructions, and then I would have other computers attached to the same home group and utilize this same password so that we can all be joined and shared our files, folders, and even our attached printers. So take some time and practice with your workgroup domain and home group settings and get comfy with it.